Hi everyone, this is Celine. Welcome to our virtual Case Club tastings. We're so happy to have you here with us today. And even though we don't get to taste wines in the fall for the fall tasting like we normally would, we're really happy to have this opportunity for you to join us and do a little bit of a walkthrough and taste with Philippe too. So to be a part of the Case Club, if you're not familiar with it, all it takes is the purchase of one case of wine a year. And as part of the Case Club, you'll get newsletters from us with different specials and discounts and invitations to member-only events and tastings. So along the way today, we will see a couple familiar faces that you might be used to seeing during the fall and spring tastings. And we'll check in with a few people. So you can follow me on in.
Check in with Rick here. Hi, welcome to the tasting. We have missed you all. It's good to have you here. Philippe is tasting some delicious wines today. If you're interested, we do have them on our website. You're always welcome to call Jane or I. We can help you if you have any questions. Also this year, we do have our pickup building open. You're welcome to drive right up to the door. You can order your wines and your spirits right there. So hopefully you'll have a great day. We know you will. Enjoy the tasting, and we hope we'll see you soon. Take care. Have fun.
Thanks, Vic. Vic has been the welcoming voice and face of the winery and the Case Club tastings for 25 years. So if you do get her on the phone with a wine order, make sure you wish her a happy 25th anniversary.
We'll head down to the cellar.
Before we get to asking Vic a couple questions, make sure you're getting your corkscrew, your glasses, and your wines ready to taste with Philippe. This here is Vic. She's been our assistant winemaker over 26 years now, and this is the cellar there where you usually see her during Case Club tastings, way down at the back, and they're tasting Domaine Reserve and Port usually. So Vic is in charge of our yeast and our barrels, and we've got a couple of questions for her. So Vic, how many barrels do we have?
Right now we have about 300 working barrels.
What type of wood are they made out of?
We have mainly two types of wood. We have French oak and American oak. American oak gives the wine a rough backbone, and a French oak gives the wine a polish and finesse, sometimes a vanilla undertone. We actually have unique barrels for Wollersheim Winery that we were the first in the nation for this program. It's a hybrid barrel, so it's 50% Wisconsin staves and 50% French oak staves. We use that in our Domaine Reserve and Domaine Reserve.
And how long do the barrels last?
Anywhere from 4 to 6 years, depending on the type of oak they are. Before we empty each barrel, we taste them and make notes. All the barrels have report cards.
It's a tough job. Someone has to do it, right?
Yes. So when we deem a barrel not wine worthy, it's just tiring out, we decide to retire it. And it goes and either gets stenciled or goes to the wood shop and the furniture is made from it.
Awesome. Thanks, Vic. Hopefully we'll see you again for the tasting later.
All right, so if you're ready to taste, we're gonna head into see Philippe. As he is talking about the wines, I will be relaying your questions to him, so bring them on.
Hello, everyone. So since I'm the last one, I can take the mask off so you can see my beautiful smile and my pretty face. Welcome to the tasting. As Vikem welcomed you and Celine told you, unfortunately, we cannot do the traditional tasting, so we are doing the virtual one. We picked and choose some of the favorite wines, some of the estate grown wines. We have a lot to tell you about all of those wines. Let's start with the growing season, for instance. Growing season this year was good. We had a mini drought, which is always good for the wine people. We had to turn irrigation on for a couple nights and a couple days in the most sensitive fields. And so it was a good year. And it will show in the 2020 vintage Domaine du Sec, Prairie Blush, Domaine Reserve, and so on. So let's start with the Eagle White that we have picked for you. Eagle is 100% estate grown. It is the 2020 vintage. It is made of Lacrosse and San Pepin vines, very aromatic. I think this is one of our better vintage. Super fruity, a little bit sweeter than the Prairie Fumé, and all grown on the estate. I am convinced this wine will win a lot of medals this year. So in the tasting, you would have had the Prairie Fumé, which is as popular as ever, the Dry Riesling and the White Riesling, and the River Gold, our sweetest white. So let's not forget all the wines that are not here with us. In the pink table, you would have had the Blushing Rose, the new Rosé, and we did change the label slightly where it's just called Rosé and not Dry Rosé, because we made it a little bit fuller, a little bit rounder, super popular, super summer picnic wine. And here for you, we have the Prairie Blush. So Prairie Blush is 100% Fauche, estate grown as well, picked early, pressed right away, and that's what gives it this beautiful iridescent pink color. Modeled after the Prairie Fumé, crisp, light, citrusy, pink lemonade-like, so awesome. You could have a shrimp cocktail with this wine, and Julie and I love Prairie Blush and drink a lot of it.
Can you tell us where on the property these are grown, what the fields are like?
Yeah, so as you come up to the winery, and if you look at the cave, everything is referenced to the cave. Eagle White would be on the right side of the cave, on the flat, actually all the fields above the distillery, what we call field 7, 12, and 13. Sometime we have left San Pepin out of one of those fields to be the ice wine. Some of you might remember taking a tour back there, but all the flat field above the distillery, that's where those whites are from. The Prairie Blush is mostly out of field 6. It is also on the flatland, Fauche vines, and then the Domaine du Sec, Domaine Reserve are on the slope on both sides of the cave, right side, left side of the cave. That's where most of the Du Sec and the Domaine Reserve is from. Domaine Reserve, I will have time to expand on it and detail that. I'm getting thirsty, so I might have to crack open one of those can or mini. Speaking of, cans, minis, available, perfect stocking item, Christmas gift. You can stick it in your purse and enjoy it once you get somewhere. Chardonnay. This is the Chardonnay cellar right here. Céline would be at this table tasting Domaine du Sec, Carignan, Pinot, and Chardonnay. Chardonnay is literally aged in those barrels right next to me. As you may see, or Jesse can zoom on it later on, they are empty right now and they will get filled either this afternoon or tomorrow morning. So Chardonnay, unlike a few years ago, is fermented in the tank to retain freshness and fruitiness, And then it comes and it does the secondary fermentation, which is the malolactic fermentation, the softening of the acid in the barrels. And it's going to sit right here for about a year. And eventually we will do what we call the batonnage, which is the steering of the sediment called surlis. And it gives the wine a creamier, softer, deeper, fuller taste, unlike a light Chardonnay. Our Chardonnay is soft, round, and buttery. Any questions, Celine?
No, but we have good morning from Aaron, and a hello from Michelle H., and Rita, Vic M's sister, who says hello and that she loves the rosés. Janine says, awesome. So thanks to everyone who's been popping on to say hi and go through some of these wines with us.
So the next would be the Domaine du Sec. Domaine du Sec is also an estate-grown red. We call it the Poor Man's Domaine Reserve. It is made of three fields. Field 19, Field 10, Field 11, it is about 80% Fauche, 20% Millau grapes. Not the complexity that the Domaine Reserve have, but more Beaujolais style, just an everyday great wine, great value, 6 months of barrel aging in the barrels that Vico was describing to you. Once the Domaine Reserve barrels are quote-unquote retired out of the Domaine Reserve, after 2 or 3 years of use of Domaine Reserve, they are shifted to Domaine du Sec. So Domaine du Sec, it doesn't have the tannin complexity that the Domaine Reserve has, but just an everyday awesome red, true to Wisconsin. It is one of my favorite. It's really my go-to red wine any day or every day. Now, the Domaine Reserve, 2019, we had only 5 barrels because of winter kiln, 18 over 19, and spring frost in 19. More issue with spring frost in 19 than we had in 20, which was great. 2020, we really didn't lose many buds. It was a welcome news, but 19 we did, and as a result, we had a small crop of Domaine Reserve. And a small crop in Domaine Reserve is a concentration. So it is a great vintage. Those of you Kids Club member buying ahead or reserving the reserve to make sure you have some, don't think of it too long, because 5 barrels will go rather fast. So grab 6 bottles, grab a case of it. And by the way, the chart of the Domaine Reserve chart is updated on the website. It has a lot of information. You know, we always encourage our guests to let the wine grow. So it ramps up for 5, 6 years, then it plateaus out for a good 5, 6, 8 years, and then it slowly declines. And we know that some vintage, it's specific to vintages, 2009, 2011, 2019, 2012, those wines will take time to grow and evolve to the peak, to the flat plateau. So you can drink them now, and I do have to do that. In my opinion, it's too young to enjoy at the moment. I'm sure a lot of you have other vintages to use up, but it is Man, it is square and perfect domain reserve, the way we like it. You know, some tannin, some body. It's a little cool right now. It would deserve to be a bit warmer. But just let it grow, let it evolve, and it will be a super, super wine in a couple of years. Domain Reserve is one field. It is the original vine that Bob and Joanne planted in 1972. It is, in my opinion, one of the most unique wine in the nation or the world, because if you think about it, it is Fauche, French American hybrid, grown on a Wisconsin terroir, on a very specific soil, 48-year-old vines, made the traditional way for since 1976 or 1977 that we had the first estate red. So very little to nothing has changed outside of the weather. And so there are not many place or not many winery to can claim to have a wine like this, that the concept of it hasn't changed over all those years. Any questions, anyone, on Domaine du Sac?
You said the Domaine du Sac was one of your favorite wines because it's light and it's easy to pair with a lot of foods. And I feel the same way at my house. I joke that it's my house wine because we have it with pizza and burgers and pretty much anything if I don't know what I want to open. What do you like to eat with the Domaine Reserve?
Well, as a Wisconsin deer hunter, backstrap, something gamey is fine. You know, duck, wild turkey, pheasant, prime rib, steaks, salmon, trout on the grill. It's a wine that can take something substantial and big. Again, that is a personal choice. So, I mean, go with really what you like, but it can take anything. I won't say spicy, not pizza spicy or not hot spicy. I don't think it would be a great match. If you wanted something spicy, I would go with more with a softer wine like the Carignan. But this is it's a substantial wine. It deserves a good match, a perfect match. Last but not least, when it comes to wine, it are the port. And when it comes to port, we have four choices. We have the white port, which is like a Muscato, very aromatic, 7 to 9 months in older Chardonnay barrels. Very aromatic from Muscat grapes. We have the Port Rosé, which is Wisconsin grown grapes and stopped early. So it's beautiful pink color, about 16-17% of alcohol, no aging, summer drink. You can fill a glass with lots of ice cube and pour some of the Port Rosé over that. And then the more traditional port is this one, what we call the regular red port, which is 13 months in the barrels. And some years are deemed to be tawny port because they are fuller, gentler, bigger, greater. Then we set aside 6 barrels, 10 barrels to become the tawny port. And I think the last tawny port that we released was 2014, and we only released 4 or 5 barrels, and we kept another 4 or 5 to push it to 10 years and possibly longer. So that's Tony Cork is really what I describe as the Corvette or the Ferrari of all wines. It is it's a step up from anything else. It would be the perfect gift for somebody difficult to find a wine for.
Speaking of, we just had a comment from Scott who said the port has gradually become his favorite. It only took 25 years of Case Club tastings to get there. So that's really cool. Thanks for sharing that, Scott.
And yeah, and you know, it's what's interesting and what we cherish to hear is so many people said, oh, I'm not really into port. I don't like port. It's just too thick. When they come to taste our port, which is made the traditional Portuguese way, where grape spirit is added during fermentation, it kills the yeast, and then the grapes are pressed immediately, and the wine that has been stopped fermenting goes directly into barrel and sits in the barrel for 13 to 14 months on the regular port, and then an additional 4, 5, 6 years for the tawny port. Our port has made a lot of friends, it's a wine that you don't have to worry about when should I drink it. And once it's open, it's good open for a month on the kitchen counter. You don't have to worry about vacuum or oxidation and so on. So just really enjoy it. It's a sipping wine. It's 20% of alcohol, so go easy. Don't go on an empty stomach. Maybe at the end of the meal, fireplace is going, and the romance is starting, and I will stop right there.
In the summer, what do you like to have port with?
Actually, port is, in Europe, is an aperitif wine. So white port, red port, a little bit before dinner, but port is always in small quantity. You know, you're talking a small serving like this, couple ounces maybe, and then a little sip at the time. But blue cheese, that would be like I'm going to say a stinky blue cheese. speaking of cheese, we have, and we know that a lot of you Kids Club members come for the wine, of course, but a lot of you also come for the cheese. We always have had an outstanding cheese selection for you to enjoy. So we have pre-packaged boxes like this with select cheeses that we would have had on the route of Case Club tasting. I think they are $20 a box. They are available at the pickup building or in the stores. So speaking of availability at the pickup building, we made for COVID safety, we made everything really hands off. You can order online, you can call Vic or Jane, you can come to the stores. Online is the easiest. You can drive through the parking lot and aim towards the pickup building. Everything is there. The spirits are there, the cans. We can even take money down there. You can do your transaction down there. You can drive to the pickup building without even calling ahead of time. You can drive to the pickup building and we can take your order, pack it in 10 minutes, and you are on the road. You don't have to get off the car. You don't have to touch anything. We will bring the box to your car with your receipt and so on and so on. We have bourbon, brandy, rye whiskey, the syrup for the old fashioned at the pickup building. Speaking of the spirit, next Wednesday, same time, in I think Tom and Celine's house, they will do a Case Club tasting, cocktail making. With the spirits. So 11:30 December 9th will be the next time we will come towards you more distillery and spirit. COVID sucks. There's no other way to put it. We feel sad to not see Case Club member, to not see customers. Thank God for the distribution, great stores supporting our brands. We love to see the wine moving, but we also miss the customer and not able to come here. So to be honest, as you get the calendar, the beautiful calendar of the winery, you will see that we do not have any events planned, unfortunately, because we don't know how long this is going to go on. We hope to be able to do the Fall Case Club tasting next year. That's right now, it's really the only event we are focusing on for next year. We are already looking at 2022, will be the 50th anniversary of the winery. So we hopefully make a big deal of that. In the meantime, stay safe, enjoy the wine, give us some feedback. We love you guys, we miss you. And cheers to 2021 and a better year. See you.